Hello friends, I am Renuka. Welcome back to my channel. And we'll make one galaxy card today. Yeah, today is not a multiple card project. It's just a one card. Cause I slowed down the process and it took a while to make this card. I use here a very old school technique where we use the crayons or the wax color, or you don't have crayons, you can use candle also. Now this heavyweight paper came with the Hero Arts last month kit. And I have two left over with that, and this is 5x7 paper. I'm just draping down it with the help of painter's tape on the chopping board. Yeah, I use lots of boards, and then I'm using these crayons, and I'm using white, yellow, and kind of little bit of orange shades there, because we are doing a watercoloring here. I will use the Mavis watercolor. We're gonna use the water resist technique here. For this kind of technique, I suggest you that you should have a really heavy weight paper. If you don't have this paper, just see that you have the 400 GSM or some kind of or you can use Prima papers also. Those are really nice papers. Don't go with the Bristol or Smirnoff. I don't know how kind of what kind of texture it's gonna get. I'll use that paper also in upcoming video to see these kind of techniques, but this will give a really nice effect. I'm using a really flat brush here and kind of big brushes like this. A round brush is like a number 10 brush. You can see that those colors are doing their own work. I just put a flat water there and those colors are spreading out, and I'm using lots of different kind of colors, the shades of purples and blues, and just go a little bit lighter way first hand. And if you want, put little bit white gaps there, that also give a nice effect. Don't add too much black at this moment because paper is too wet. Just see what you can add, and I'll suggest you, rather than adding black, you can add little bit of blue color in that, or you can add little bit black in blue color, so that also give a nice effect here. Now you can see that where we create that planet, those kind of give you a kind of resisting, but still they can seep little bit of color. Now I purposely dry that layer, and now I'm just adding this white acrylic paint here. I'm using acrylic paint because this will not resist the water, and it's kind of giving a nice really white color there, and still you can see those layers inside. And I'm just adding a little bit of splatters there to make really kind of starry things, and putting some of them, like the bigger the brush, the bigger the splatter, the smaller number brush, the smaller the splatter. Now I'm using the heat gun to heat this to just speed up the process a little bit, and I'm kind of making this in layers and layers, and you can do work on it until you get desired effect. Now I'm adding a little bit of color on those acrylic white paint, and you can see that how that gonna pop those planets, cause otherwise the water white color is gonna mix in that, and you didn't get that crisp and you know kind of nice image. Now I'll just zoom out and see that how that acrylic also works nice, and I'm adding a little bit of purple and little bit of red to just kind giving kind of sphere shape to it. And now I'm using this Hero Arts kit, and I'm using that star things there, and I'm using white pigment ink. Although I know that my white pigment ink not gonna work, and here I'm seeing my options that I can use this and put little bit clouds there or moons there. And after adding that pigment ink, it didn't work really well. It kind of faded out a little bit after drying. So I use this white gel pen, Uniball white gel pen, and I add a couple of stars. I draw some of them and I just redraw whatever I stamp. After this, I'm quite happy with the image. And then I just peel off all that painter's tape and then see how it's look. More the color seepage is there, so I decided I will not put whole panel there, although you can put this whole panel by adding little bit of washi tape, the glittery washi tape all around it to make it kind of frame, or the black paper kind of make it frame. But I decided to go ahead and mat there on a black cardstock to make that kind of frame, and then I'll trim it off a little bit, and then I'll put the whole panel on the white 5x7 cardstock. And then these are the couple of options that you can put on this Galaxy and what came in this kit. But then I decided I will not put any of those elements, because I love that background so much. I don't want to destroy or distract anything on that. So I just decided to stamp the sentiment there. And as this paper is very much on texture and all, I can't emboss or stamp on this paper nicely. So I decided to use the vellum, and I'm using plain white color vellum, and you can go ahead with golden also. And then I'm adding again those sparkly tapes which I have left over from the Hero Arts My Monthly kit. And this finishes card, and if recipient wants to, he or she can just tear it off that thing and put it like a frame, like an art piece. And yeah, I'm really happy how it turned out, and it's really simple. And you are doing all this technique in your school, just putting lots of water on the crayons, and then you can just put the colors. I don't have any reference image for this. I just imagine and put those colors. But if you want to, you can go to Pinterest or Google search the images of galaxies, and then you can choose the colors, or by the taking reference of them, you can create a beautiful galaxies, the starry things and everything. Now I have this Samus staff which having the long strip of those stars. I decided to add that inside and stamp that sentiment again in a black blue ink, and I'm using here Momento blue ink. And this really turned out really nice and beautiful cards. I didn't make the matching envelope this time. I decided to make matching envelopes at the end of the video, where I can review all the stuff and show you that how you can create little bit stamps there to create the. These are some close-ups of the textured cardstock, and I had couple of stars there, the silvery stars with the Darcy one. And I hope you liking this series and you kind of get kind of inspiration with it. These are the simple things and techniques that you can create much more with that. You can follow me on social media. You can subscribe to my channel if you like my video. And I love to read your comments, and I always want to say thank you for all those appreciation, love, and it's really overwhelming. And thank you. So until the next crafty project, have a crafty life. Bye bye.